So maybe I have to prop it like this for now because I cannot get it to just stay on that one position for more than 5 seconds without it falling, and it's pissing me the fuck off because I'm already like trying to get some rest before I go to class. My class starts at 11, so I'm thinking if I get to sleep by like 9:30, I can probably wake up by either 10:30 or 10:45. Then, get prepared, like probably refix my hair, and then I can go to class and work on this paper that I really didn't spend too much time on, and another paper I have to work on for today, which is about transgender rights. And what annoys me is that none of the people in my section of the debate know what the fuck they are doing. They don't know what the fuck they are doing. It's new to them. Why would you pick a topic that you know nothing about, are not trying to research, aren't trying to look up information from people who are transgender, but want to sit up here and just ignore everything I said? Don't you hate when you are a black person working with a bunch of white people and you are telling them what to do and then they don't want to listen to you, or they want to act like what you are saying is completely crazy? Like, that's what I fucking hate. And then that's how a lot of times we end up failing these things because they keep trying to give you the wrong information, or they want to tell you what to do. Like, oh, why don't you do it on the religion? Because I'm not good with religion. I don't like religion. I don't really like to talk about religion because religion is just something that I don't really care to delve in. So I hate when people try to like make decisions. Like, why don't you do this? Why don't you do the hardest shit while I do something totally easy? Because I'm fucking lazy and I don't want to go outside of my realm of knowledge. Like, that's what I see all the time. And I'm just not here for it. I'm just not here for this section of the class because no one knows what they are doing. They don't know shit about transgender rights. This is about the Gavin issue, I believe, in North Carolina or somewhere. It may not be North Carolina, but I know that there are transgender issues in North Carolina. Laverne Cox said it on her live the other night. But this is about whether trans people should be able to use the bathroom of their real gender or not. They say identified gender, but I'm going to say like their gender, like the gender that they say that they are, that they clearly are, that they weren't assigned at birth as. Obviously, I'm on the pro side. Yes, they should. And then everyone's like, I don't really know because I don't want to sound like I'm against it. I don't want to sound like a bitch you are against it because you don't know what the fuck you are talking about. Like, the issue is you don't want to sound transphobic when clearly you are. You don't want to sound like you are a bigot of trans people, but then you also don't want to sound like you are supporting something because you don't believe that. Say, for instance, a trans woman is a woman, and that's all that is. Like, you want to sit up here and try to say, well, I don't want to sound like I'm against it. Like, people don't know what the fuck they are doing. They don't know how to debate. And then they keep referencing the fact that, oh, my trans friend, like, shut up. Like, I hate working in groups sometimes because when you are actually doing something correct, everyone else wants to act like you are slow and that you don't know what you're doing, and then they want you to work at their pace. I can't for the life. I cannot for the life of me just comprehend. And I'm already stressed enough because school ends in like maybe 3, 4 weeks tops. I hate that it's so dark in here and that you cannot fucking see me. If I had positioned in a different type of way, then you probably would. But since it keeps sliding off, this is what you are going to get for now. Let's talk about a few things when it comes to critiques and criticisms. Well, here's the thing, critiques versus criticism. Critique is where you point out, how you feel about a subject in a critical manner. Like, you don't have to say something negative. Critique is to say, this is how I feel about this. These are the pros and cons of this. This is why this is what it is. Like, you are analyzing something. Criticizing something is to mainly point out something negative or to say what are the flaws and cons of something. That's how I look at it. Now, let's talk about how people want to criticize people but not really do anything to help them or to actually get to the root of an issue. Tyrese Gibson, you tried it. And I'm sick of you. I'm sick of you saying things just to be relevant. And I saw that little interview you did with the Breakfast Club where you was cheering because your mixed race wife is 46% black. I don't care, but you clearly got with this woman with the knowledge in your head that she is a woman of color that may or may not be black. So you got with her with a color-struck mindset, and then you wanted her to be black so you wouldn't look like, or as you said, be pinged as the guy that would get put on and be with a non-black woman. But you are. You really are. You are a sellout because you go from a guy, you know, that actually celebrates being dark-skinned and talking about how hard it is to be a dark-skinned man in the industry, but then clearly show your insecurity by dating women lighter than you, and just making these condescending comments towards black women, especially dark-skinned black women. And this is what I hate. Everyone wants to sit there and say, oh, he can like dark-skinned women, he can like black women, and still date a non-black woman. No, I hate when people who aren't interested in someone or who aren't actively dating someone wants to tell them how to live their life. I don't know, Tyrese, are you cheating on your wife with a black woman? Is this what this is about? Is like a dark-skinned black woman with a fat ass your mistress and you feel the need to justify it by saying, well, she's a hoe and, you know, you dress like you're cheating. You're cheating on your wife. And whether she's smart or not, I don't know, but I wouldn't be with you. I wouldn't. Because this doesn't make any sense that you keep harping on the fact that black women want to do whatever they want to do with their bodies. And people are sitting here justifying it like, well, you wouldn't want to be with a man who sleeps around, flirts with a lot of people, and you're trying to be in a committed relationship. This is not the point. One, if you are dating someone, you're going to encounter someone who's dating multiple people. Now, I understand people want to have a monogamous relationship. I believe it's bullshit to sit there and say monogamy is not realistic. Because if you want to cheat, cheat. You don't have to make up some bullshit excuse like, well, monogamy is a social construct. Bitch, you are hurting people. I don't care if you don't like monogamy. You cheat because you are selfish and you could care less if you hurt people. That's what that is. But this whole thing with people that want to sit here and act as if the issue is non-committal people. No, the issue isn't non-committal people. The issue is Tyrese attacking women who are expressing themselves. Tyrese attacking women he feels do not fit the ideal of a woman. Women who may dress a certain way. Women who may talk a certain way. Women who may go out and party. We're not talking about you are trying to date someone and they aren't taking the relationship seriously. Like, I can see if men were wanting to say, well, I don't want a woman that cheats or just flirts with a bunch of men and does not respect the relationship that she is currently in. I can see that, but 9 out of 10 times, that's not the case. And even then, you shouldn't have to beat on someone. You shouldn't have to call someone out their name or call them a slut or say all types of bigoted slurs just because they aren't being a good person. You shouldn't conflate with someone's bad behavior to other people. You shouldn't use slurs like slut or hoe to judge a woman, especially if you ain't saying that to a man. So this has nothing to do with the fact that Tyrese is just saying, you know, if you don't take your relationship seriously, no one is ever going to wife you up, or you're never going to find that partner because you want to play around. You want to be silly. You just want to talk to everyone. You can't just settle down. And I've been in situations. As a woman, I wouldn't want to be with a man who doesn't take the relationship seriously. I wouldn't want to be with a man who is flirting with other people, who is sleeping around, you know, doesn't want to settle down. I wouldn't want to be with that because I want to settle down. And I wouldn't expect that from men who also want to settle down when it comes to other women. I understand that. But what you are doing is slut shaming. You are making people feel bad about themselves because of their expression. That's what it is, Tyrese. You are making women feel like shit because you don't like how they dress or you don't like how they talk. You are making individuals feel low about themselves. It's nasty, it's hateful, it's hurtful. You are saying hurtful things to other people. And the thing of the matter is, if someone is in a committed relationship with you, you wouldn't have to worry about being so-called hoes. You wouldn't have to worry about them going around flirting with other people because it's about trust. Are you talking about the fact that if you meet a woman who is like just flirting around, just talking to a bunch of people, who is engaging in philanderous activities with other people, and you aren't in a relationship with her at the moment, and you are talking about being with her, and she's single, so she can do what she wants. Are you talking about, if you ever done that stuff in the past, if you ever slept around, if you ever partied and acted a fool, you can never get wifed up? Is that what you are saying? Because that logic doesn't make any sense, especially when so many men who are in these so-called good relationships come from terrible relationships where they have cheated on girls, they have beat it on these girls, they have abused these girls, treated them like shit, but then they are with this perfect girl. So it's like you are saying women who at one time weren't responsible in a relationship can never settle down, but men can settle down. You know, women, you know, we're just sirens, we are Jezebels, you know, like we are nothing but whores and hoes. Like, that's what it sounds like to me. It doesn't make any sense. I cannot stand Tyrese. I never liked Tyrese. You know, I haven't listened to a song of his in years. I don't even remember like his song, to be honest. I remember Tank's song more than Tyrese. And I remember Tank said something a couple of years ago about dark-skinned women and how they were mad about his light-skinned wife or light-skinned girlfriend. And let me tell you this, does it get your dick hard for women that you are clearly attracted to feel as if they are jealous? Like, because it really feels as if it makes you feel like a man, or it makes you feel like you are the man if you get a bunch of women jealous of you. Because y'all can sit here and talk about how black women are this and that. You can call us ugly, you can call us names, but at the end of the day, your physical attraction to black women is evident. You don't like our personality. You don't like the fact that we're black women, but your physical attraction is evident. And the fact of the matter is, you cannot control your impulses to save your life. You cannot do that. Let me try to get this, because it's still coming up. Let me have this right here, because speaking of which, like I said, yeah, as you can see, my baby hair is coming in nice. I took my braids out, obviously, so I usually wear my hair like this. Oh my god, but the issue is one of my hairs broke off, because like it came off with the braids, so now it's just like a strip of hair just hanging just like this, and it's supposed to be brushed in the back. It's supposed to be brushed with the rest of my hair, but it broke off, so I wonder if I can like just cut this off or get a hairdresser to cut this off. And I don't think it would notice. I think she just has to clip this off and then this would like just grow back. It's not like a big deal. Like, I don't think it's that noticeable. It's like when I got my cavity riddled tooth removed, and it wasn't noticeable because it's like all the way in the back. So like, it's like I got no tooth removed. So I think I could just like have someone just cut this all off and then like start over. But I wouldn't want her to fucking try to do anything like cut it off, because I feel like some hairdressers be like trying to sit there and say you need to have something trimmed off, and it really doesn't need to be trimmed, so you have to start over, especially when it comes to like black hair. I know that some hairdressers will really try to like convince you to cut it off, especially if you are trying to grow out hair like this, like 4C hair. They will really try to get you to like cut it off, because for some reason they don't like 4C hair to grow. For some reason. But anyway, yeah, with this whole Tyrese Gibson thing, I don't respect him. I don't respect it. As someone else said, you know, prayers to his wife, but if his wife is also obnoxious, then she can go to hell as well. Because I can never understand a complicit woman. I can never understand a woman who wants to sit here and be married to a man who is obsessed with what other women do. I mean, that must be draining to like be this status symbol for your husband, but clearly your husband isn't like that into you if he's so worried about what other women do with their bodies and wants to sit here and act like he everybody's daddy. And that's what I don't understand. Like, you are not people's daddy, Tyrese. You are just an ugly ass nigga that wants to sit up here judging other women. Because you are ugly as shit. Like, I don't understand. Like, and someone said, oh, his skin used to be so pretty. Like, he really does look like a melting milk dud. Because it's just like, the fuck happened? Like, because you weren't that bad looking. Because I remember, I did see some of your pictures. I thought he had the prettiest skin. But, like, yeah, you just don't look good. You look aging. And the secret to aging well is to not be a coon, obviously, because as we see, a lot of people that just been saying a bunch of fucked up shit have just... This is ridiculous. I don't understand fucking anything about this fucking phone or why it fucking wants to fucking do what it does. Because, like, you can barely see. I'm trying to fucking do it in a way where you can, like, at least see. Because it is too damn dark in here. Like, because no way. No freaking way. This a certain position, whatever. I hate people that always have something to say about other people but then don't want to back it up. I hate people that talk about how they want to help others but you just want to put them down and make them feel like shit. And that's what it is, Tyrese. That's all it is. Moving on, Fritos Pinto Bean from Slumdog Millionaire, and you are a slum, you are a scum, I fucking hate you. Well, I don't really hate you, but any non-black woman of color that wants to cry when two black women are asking you about the presence of black women in a film that is supposed to represent the Black Panther movement of the UK, you're trash to me. I don't understand how it's such a burden to just include black women in the movement, especially when we did. Well, not me, because this is a Black British issue. I'm not going to speak too much on it, but I'm just annoyed in general by how Black women keep being erased from the movement. Black women keep being put to the side just for some ignorant interracial story between a Black man and a non-Black woman. And I don't know why Black men are so obsessed with interracial stories. Like, it does nothing. Like, it really does nothing. Like, a lot of times interracial relationships are hateful. They are terrible. They are nothing. But I'm not saying, oh, no, I'm not saying that. Like, I didn't want you to think that, because, like, it sounded like I was saying that's how they were. But I mean, like, in terms of, like, when a black man gets with a white woman, a lot of times it's out of hatred for black women. The white woman is racist and cannot stand black women herself. So it's just this, like, these two hateful, toxic people that have a common interest of just street harassing or harassing black women in public whenever they are around. I've told you so many times before that whenever I see an interracial couple, they will try to do something sly or try to cut me off. Like, one time I was walking with my mom and we had a bunch of stuff in our hand. It was at a dorm and there was this black man and white woman together. They saw we had stuff in our hand and they just sat there and let us, like, they did not hold the door for us. They let it close. We didn't say anything. We just stood. And my mom said, you know, they could have, like, held it. I don't know. They're fucking ignorant as shit. Like, that was ignorant. But there are interracial couples that really add nothing to social justice of Earth. They don't. Like, they do nothing but promote this rainbow coalition idea where they don't see color. It's dangerous. It's this ideal that I can have mixed race children and not really have them identify as black and prove that race is a social construct and prove that in order to avoid racism, you can just come out as ambiguous as possible or light skinned as possible. As we said before, that's not the case with every mixed race person. Every biracial person is not light skin with curly hair, green eyes. People have my type of hair. But Fritos and what's his name? John Ridley? Ridley Scott. Actually, Ridley Scott's probably a better director than this man. But John Ridley apparently directed 12 Years a Slave. And I'm only saying his name right because I want you to know who the fuck this man is. He directed 12 Years a Slave. And people made a point to say, so you can get off on black women being raped on screen, being beaten on screen. But then when it comes to our actual contribution to the movement, we're not there. You know, we're not at the forefront. We're not standing by your side. It's some South Asian woman who is doctored on the photo of a black woman with an afro, and you just want to put this ugly bitch's face on it. And I will say that she's an ugly bitch because her personality just seems like she, like, when you say something or do something ugly or ignorant, you look ugly to me. I don't care what you look like. I don't care who you are. You just ugly to me. Like, when people act a certain way or when people say certain things, you look like an ugly witch. You look like that witch from Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, where she was supposed to be this physically ravishingly beautiful woman, but then she turned into this old hag, which is ages as hell. I'm going to give it that. But, you know, that's just how it is to me. Like, you can be the most attractive person in the world, but when you do ignorant things, when you are just trying to harm groups of people, you are ugly to me. So, fuck Fritos. I'm not gonna say her name right. You know who I'm talking about. Like, I don't respect her enough. I don't respect anyone that wants to be anti-black and use this idea of political blackness to erase black women. Apparently, political blackness is a problematic construct of the UK, where black people aren't just black people, it's brown people. Like, black means, like, I guess black in that context means anyone that is brown. But that's what brown is. Brown means anyone that is other than black. So a brown person can be Asian. A brown person can be a non-black indigenous person of the Americas, or like in places in Europe. Like, that's what brown means. You don't have to use black to mean all type of black people. This isn't Do the Right Thing, where the Asian man that didn't want to get his store burned down said, I'm black. Because I guess he was trying to say that he wasn't white, that he was of color, and the only thing he could say was that he was black, like the other people. So that type of political blackness, which I'm not here for, no one was here for, political blackness was a problem in the 1970s, and it still is today. But I'm sick of black women being erased from the movement. Like, you can sit here and compliment us, you can sit here and call us beautiful and say all of that, but if you are willing to erase us, if you are willing to sit here and say that our opinions are petty, frivolous, and they don't matter, then fuck you. Because no amount of compliments or praise can erase the fact that you are a misogynistic piece of shit. Like, I've had people try to sit here and say, well, I don't see the issue with 4C here because I find it beautiful. But these people are willing to erase the fact that 4C hair exists. These people are willing to sit here and allow Kendrick Lamar to sit there and say, oh, I want a girl with Richard Pryor afro hair, but then cast a girl with clearly, with hair that's clearly not 4C, hair that's clearly not an afro. It's not an afro. I don't know what you imagine to be an afro, but that is not it. It's not it, and I will continue to talk about it. Like, I follow people who say they didn't find the problem with Kendrick Lamar's video. Fine. I can see why you wouldn't find it a problem, but I did. That's my opinion. I found it problematic. I found it misogynistic. I found it cliche. I found it played out. You know, you cannot find an issue with something. You can like Kendrick Lamar, but I feel like a lot of people let Kendrick Lamar get the best of their opinions. Like, I don't like Kendrick Lamar because he sat there, when he was asked about Mike Brown, he said, well, that was terrible, but if you don't respect yourself, then how can you expect the police to respect you? That was his response. He defended Iggy Azalea. So why are we trying to tote this man as this savior of hip-hop and how he's pro-black and he's for divorce? He's not. He's a conservative. He's a black conservative. He is a woke conservative. That's what it is. He's Hotep, a conservative ass nigga. And that's what Kendrick Lamar will always be to me. But what was I saying? Because I went on a tangent, but just about how, yeah, about the natural hair thing. Like, you can sit here and compliment us and say, oh, I think 4C hair is beautiful. But if you aren't trying to show that it's beautiful, then what are you talking about? If you aren't trying to show that black women are beautiful, then what are you talking about? Why are you willing to hide something that is so beautiful unless your logic is fucked up? Like, well, because I don't want other people to look at it, which is a fucked up type of logic. Black men use this shit all the time when it comes to how they don't want to degrade us. So they use other women to take our place, which is bullshit. Just say you find those women more attractive, or you are attracted to those women. You don't have to make up excuses to make it sound better than what it actually is. Erasure. It's erasure. It is. And it's you're gaslighting people. You're sitting up here saying there's no issue with how someone looks, but then you're clearly trying to hide how they look. You're trying to hide their feature. You're trying to make it like they don't exist. You're trying to erase them. You're trying to act as if, like, it's not common to have this type of hair. You want to act like, you know, having long hair and like hair that's like loose curl is like the ideal. And then when people call you out on it, you want to go on this spiel on how, oh, am I not natural enough? Like, shut up, bitch. And it's always the bitches that get the most attention. I want to sit here and say they aren't enough. Like, bitch, shut up. Because it was you that sat there and talked about my hair texture. When I was transitioning, y'all were the main ones sitting up here laughing at me or jumping in conversations about natural hair and wanting to show off your fucking hair texture. And then when I showed you my hair texture, you sat there and laughed and told me to untag you. That happened. That really happened. Some cunt jumped into my mentions when I was talking about my curl pattern, and she wanted to sit here and show me pictures of her hair. So then when I showed her a picture of like what my hair looked like, because I wasn't going to show her my hair, she sat there because I saw a little subtweet she made about how I needed to untag her, and she just laughed. Like, bitch, shut the fuck up. And this is what happens when you jump into a conversation and you don't really know what you're talking about or you don't know what's going on. So you want to sit here and act as if you understand, but you really don't. I'm going to use this real quick because I love it. I've been used this in years, probably since maybe the early 2000s, but this Queen Helene's 100% cocoa butter is the truth. It will cure chapness. I wouldn't recommend it to just cure ashiness. This is something that the black daddies recommended. Like, my black daddy always sat there and said, you need this. This is the cure for ashiness. I don't think it's like the soul cure for ashiness. I think it helps. This helps with scars. This helps with stretch marks. This, like, you know, so much serum into this. Like, as I said, cocoa butter is my elixir. Reese King would agree on a fucking live that I did, like, he did a live and, like, he responded to my comment. I'm ugly as hell, but I'm obsessed with this. I really am. This is like probably $1.75 at the Dollar General I am from. I really love this. Just because, like, it's just so fun to use. Like, it's better than an EOS. Like, I don't understand these EOS things because they do nothing for my lips. I guess they are just fun to look at. But they really did nothing. But right now, it's just my lips are just so pink and moist. And I love it. Like I said, I wouldn't just use it just to like cure ashiness. I feel like maybe if you are like at a moment's notice you're getting ashy, you would put it on, but you do need to put on lotion as well. Like, my dad was one of those country guys that would just feel like black and white ointment is like the only thing you need. Cocoa butter is the only thing you need. Like, you don't need to like put lotion on it or anything. Like, he was one of those country niggas, and it's okay. But you know how black daddies are, or black mamas that feel like everything is the cure, Robitussin, that type of stuff. But yeah, back to the whole natural hair issue. If you ain't trying to show all types of beauty, I don't want you here talking about how our hair is beautiful, but yet you ain't willing to show it. If you're sitting there saying like our hair texture is the most beautiful, but then you're willing to erase it, you're willing to sit here and put our hair to the side because your logic is that we get enough attention, as if like having 4C hair, being dark skinned, or being black is the status quo. And some people are weird as hell with that shit. Like, you talking about how, oh, God forbid he doesn't date a black woman, as if dating a black woman is the status quo. I don't understand that type of logic where you act as if black women are some type of standard that everyone has to adhere by. And then when someone refuses, it's like, wow, he beat the status quo. Like, wow. It's not like someone refusing to date a white woman or a blonde, skinny, pale woman. Like, I don't understand your logic. It's a paradox being a black woman. It really is. And like, it is so annoying. Like, I love being a black woman, but I hate being around people that fetishize black women, that act as if being a black woman is like terrible, or want to sit here and gaslight black women. It's very hard because you are constantly being gaslighted. It's turned into a looks versus bad looks issue where, well, you're not ugly, you're not that dark. And let me tell you something. I'm sick of people sitting there saying I'm not that dark. I understand I'm not that dark. I know I'm not that dark. I've met people darker than me. My whole side of my dad's family are darker than me, except my cousin, and he's high yellow. We were the yellow kids. I can admit that. I got a tan right now because like it was like 80 degrees outside. I know I'm not that dark, But I hate when people say that because I feel like they're trying to compliment me. I feel like they're trying to assure me like, oh, you're not dark skinned. You're like the good type of light. You're like a safe brown. And that's annoying. It really is. And especially when we were calling out the Kendrick Lamar casting and how we said the girl was light skinned with like curly hair and like she was just... I don't have a problem with the girl because I got to be careful saying things about certain people because some people may take it the wrong way. They may feel like it's an attack on their character and it's not. But if you are talking about natural and you only show an image of a dark skinned woman with her ass out and you don't see her face, but then you see a lighter skinned woman. She was a lighter skinned woman with 3C hair. Yes, it is a colorism issue. You can write think pieces on it. You don't have to read the think pieces. You don't have to read the threads. Like, I don't understand why people complain about threads on Twitter. Why are you complaining about threads? Threads are something that you don't have to read. But yeah, these people are reading whole ass threads. And then when we ask them, you know, why are you reading this if you don't like it? Well, it's a public domain or it's public. No, you read it because you wanted to. You wanted to be annoying and then you got caught out on it and you really don't know why you read it. So now you try to make excuses like, well, it's public. It was out there. No, because you chose to do it and you realize how stupid you look by sitting there acting like you hate something, but yeah, you clearly subjected yourself to it. So I'm sick of people just fussing at the fact that people are writing dreads because it's not like you can look at the dreads all at once. You have to click on it to read it. Like, that's why I don't understand. Why are you complaining about threads? Like, you are sitting here just seeing the whole thing. I can see if you're looking at Twitter and all you see are these people's tweets. But no, you have to click on the tweet to see the whole thread. So don't fucking complain about a thread because it's something that is optional. You can just retweet something and say thread and then other people can go on it and then read the whole thing. Like, they have stories. So it's not something that you're just seeing all over the place. It's contained. So I can't understand it. But when people brought up the fact that she was a lighter skinned girl, oh, well, she's not even Odie Lye, like she's brown. But yet when I talk about something or when I talk about colorism, suddenly it's you're not that dark. Actually, you're light skinned to me. Actually, you're yellow. So and then they want to compare me to a photo of me like with lighting in a car, or they want to compare me to like a picture where it's whitewashed and it's not on purpose. And then want to sit here and say I'm light-skinned, but not understand, like, you can clearly see that I'm not high yellow. You can clearly see that I'm not, like, Rihanna's color or even Beyonce's color. Like, Beyonce, if Beyonce were sitting next to me, maybe she'd be, like, maybe a shade or two lighter. But she'd be evidently brown and I'd be, like, no, she'd be evidently, like, yellow. And then I'd be, like, brown. So she's probably, like, maybe a shade or two. Like, she's probably my uncle's color. I'm not going to lie. But I think people need to realize you can't compare somebody's picture to like what they are in real life. If I say I'm brown skinned, then you best believe it. So I do find it funny how people will defend actual light skinned girls and say they aren't that light and that they are brown. So they can make it okay to utilize colorism. But then when it comes to me, I want to sit here and say, well, you're not that dark. You're actually light skinned. And to be annoying, not because you're actually pointing out like an obvious fact, but because you want to silence someone or erase someone's valid critiques on colorism and light skin privilege, something that I don't experience, you know, like, because I'm one of those people where I could be in a room full of white people and I'm clearly brown. I'm clearly not a light skinned person. Like, even with people as pale as me, or not as pale as me, like, even around people who are, like, clearly as pale as, like, a lot of white people are, like a Taylor Swift, I would be the dark person. Like, no doubt about it. This isn't like Cardi B or Beyonce hanging around them. This is like someone like my color now. Like, I am not light skinned to the point where I could blend in with a white person. Like, if I'm in a room with white people, I'm clearly like a brown person. I'm clearly brown. When I'm around other black people, then I would be like a light skinned person or at least on the lighter side. But then there's black people who are lighter than me. But I guess where I'm from, the majority of people are brown or dark skinned, so I would be considered like the light skinned person. And I've had been told by other light skinned people, like, well, if you're around other black people, you would tend to be the light skinned person or one of the lighter skinned people or on the light skinned side. Because there's different shades to light skin, But I just want people to shut the fuck up. Like, when we are speaking of colorism, like, everyone knows they are light-skinned. Like, you keep saying that because you want to erase someone's experience, or you want to make it like, well, you didn't really experience that colorism. Like, make it like we are just lying about how we experience colorism for having brown skin or having, like, a darker shade of brown. Like, that's ignorant as hell. That's all I have to say for now. And I wasn't intending for this video to be that long, but you get the point. Have a great day. I'm going to try to take a nap now. It won't be successful. I can tell you that now. But